Christ, whose human word designed to strengthen tidings of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. I tell myself that the future is lost, all that I hope for from the Lord. The thought of my homeless poverty is one wooden gall. Remembering it over and over leaves my soul downcast within me. But I will call this to mind as my reason to have hope. The favors of the Lord are not exhausted. His mercies are not spent. They are renewed each morning. So great is his faithfulness. My portion is the Lord, says my soul. Therefore will I hope in him. Good is the Lord to one who waits for him, to the soul that seeks him. It is good to hope in silence for the saving help of the Lord. It is good for a man to bear the yoke from his youth. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thanks. On one occasion, Jesus said, "Father, Lord of heaven and earth, to you I offer praise, which was hidden from the learned and the clever and revealed to the merest children. Father, it is true. You have graciously willed it so. Everything has been given over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son but the Father, no one knows the Father but the Son, and anyone whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who are weary and find life burdensome, and I will refresh you. Take my yoke upon your shoulders and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble of heart. Your soul will find rest, for my yoke is easy and my burden light." My brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. First of all, please be seated. Good morning, everyone. Thank you. If you ever been a visitor or stopped by St. Mary's Rectory and you walk into the office of where our secretary Rita sits, I think Vincenzo, I think you've been to her desk a couple of times when you come in. To the right of her desk is a photocopier, and on the wall there is an image. It's a picture entitled "In His Image," and it's the face of Jesus Christ. But the portrait is an interesting one, and there's an interesting story behind it, and I bring it up today for an interesting reason. There was an artist in the late 60s, early 70s, who was struggling with his career. And he said to Jesus, or he prayed one night, he said, "Lord, if you help me, I will find some way in which to honor you." And so he sat down and began to create this image. And it's the face of Jesus. But within it is probably about 50 other faces. Some of them are famous presidents like John F. Kennedy, Martin Luther King Jr., Malcolm X, Pope John the 23rd, Pope Paul the 6th, Alexander Graham Bell, Jonas Salk, and a slew of people who probably live in his neighborhood, the faces of children. And when you stand up looking at the picture, all you see are these people. But when you step back, you see the face of Jesus. And also you understand that the central teaching of our church, that each and every one of us are such a unique and special gift that we make up what they call the mystical body of Christ, that we are Jesus, and that our Lord invites us in our life to make a difference with our life. He invites us to know him, to love him, to serve him, and to be happy with him. And I think as we come this morning, many of us would love to go down to North Carolina and couldn't get there for Joseph's funeral. So we're here. Because Joseph was not only a piece in that image of Christ, but he was a piece of the fabric of our lives. Such an important part of our life. Joseph was born, obviously. He was baptized, obviously. And on his baptism day, Jesus promised Job two things. He promised him that he would love him forever. And he promised him eternal life. And then Joseph was sent on an incredible journey of faith, seeking understanding. A journey in which he would learn about our Lord in the halls of St. Mary's School, where he was a student. And that's why it's appropriate that we come back to where he learned the love of Jesus. Joseph also learned it in his own home. St. Paul the 6th said these words about the church at the Vatican Council, where the family was. The family is a domestic ecclesia, the little church. And it was in that moment that Joseph learned the most valuable lesson of all, that he was loved by his mother and his father, his sisters, his family, and that Joseph was a unique part of our lives. He became an important instrument for us. When he moved to North Carolina, because North Carolina is not an hour far, right, from here to go visit him. But God bless him. It was the only gig. He gave him a perfect name. He liked working with wood, like the other carpenter, Joseph. another. I don't know why you like the Yankees. I often tease people as, you know, if I bleed, I bleed blue and orange, and some kid literally took that. You know, you wanted to see that when I was donating blood one day. But Joseph was a diehard Yankee fan. We'll forgive him for that. You know, but he instilled into his children, too. He instilled into his children what his parents had instilled into him, that his boys loved. You know, and that they would come to know that and share with them and treasured memories. And I say, you know, our Lord invited Joseph to know him, to love him, to serve him, and to be happy with him. Our Lord extended many invitations to Job, many of them to know love, many of them to know sacrifice, many of them to know that he was loved. But the last invitation that Joseph received was an invitation nobody likes to receive, to carry a cross. A cross we call peace. Remember one time I heard as Jim Valvano addressed the nation, he said these numbers that 25% of people we know, one out of every four, contact some form of cancer in their life. It's scary when you're sitting at a table with four people. Joseph had a cross. A cross he didn't build for himself. A cross that he embraced. A cross that he carried. And a cross that he fought all the way to the end of his life. And then, it was a couple of weeks ago, just before he passed, when Vincenzo came up to me after 8 o'clock mass. It was the 9 o'clock mass on the weekday morning. I was preparing for a funeral. Would you like to see my son and my grandchildren in the picture? And you can see the love of those boys and their father. Shortly after that, Jesus made a trip to North Carolina. Jesus came to Job's home. Jesus came and looked at your son, your brother, your uncle. And as Jesus looked at him, he probably said these words to him, "Well done, Job. You've learned your lessons well." And Jesus stretched out his arms and took the cross off of Job's shoulders. And then with his other arm, he embraced him in God's love. No more pain, no more crosses, no more cancer. Job leaves behind for us a legacy of love, a legacy which he knew it, that he was loved by us, that we were a part of the fabric of his life as he was a part of the fabric of our life. And in gratitude, we come to Jesus. We come in thanksgiving. We come in thanksgiving for the gift of who Job was and is. We thank God for the gift of Job's spirit, part of his heart, still beats in the heart of the people who loved him. And we give thanks to the Lord for Job's life. It doesn't make life any easier for us. But we also know this part. At the end of a long life, when our Lord comes to greet us, our Lord will be there and he'll embrace us in his arms. He'll lead us to the fulfillment of the promise he made. And on that other side, there is Job, waiting to hug us, waiting to tell us a joke, waiting just to remind us of how much an important part of his life we were. May the love of Jesus that Job knew, may the love of Jesus that we know, may that love of the Lord today hold Job in the palm of his hands and heal our broken heart so that we too may rejoice with our brother in heaven. And thank God for the gift of who Job is.
I saw the police stand for it.
Christ is risen from the dead and sits at the right hand of the Father, where he intercedes for his church. Confident that God hears the voice of those who trust in the Lord, we now join our prayers to his. Our response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. In baptism, Joseph received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and over the waters of death, we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. My brother was nourished at the table of the sea. Welcome him to the walls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Many friends and members of our family have gone before us and with the kingdom. Grant him an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Those who trust in the Lord Jesus must lead to the Lord. The refreshing rest of his soul's faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the family and friends of Joseph, seek comfort, consolation, heal, and peace, though the darts of doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord. We are assembled here in faith and confidence, pray for our brethren. Strengthen hope that we live in the expectation of your Son's coming. For we ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord God, give your peace in your souls, hear the prayers of you, Jesus, by the person, the voice of your wild words, for the love of the Lamb. Forgive the sins of others in Christ, grant them a place in your heavenly kingdom. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Let us also please be seated for all for the beginning of the gifts.
Thank you.
proud and good and good of all this holy church. Now, gentlemen, present to you these sacrificial offerings of the Lord for the salvation of your servant Joseph. We beseech your mercy, that you do not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior, we find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Lift up your hearts, we lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him, the hope of the blessed resurrection is dawn. For those sad by the certainty of dying, let be consoled by the promise of immortality which will come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, the eternal dwelling will be ready for them in heaven. And so they can mark in front of them in all the hosts and powers of heaven. We sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Constant intercession, present life, and fulfilling help, may the sacrifice of a reconciliation and prayer, Lord. fervent faith and charity in the Little Church on Earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, Timothy, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, the entire people who have gained from your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family and summoned before them. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Joseph, who called today from this world. Grant that he was united with his son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. When from the earth he will raise up the flesh of those who die, and transform our holy body after the power of our glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters who are using the passage of this life, give kind witness to your kingdom. They will hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. When you wipe away every tear from our eyes, we'll see your God as you are. We shall be like you for all ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, who is on this world, all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
communion, I'll start on this side of the church first. My right or left, Joe's family side, and then we'll do the left side. Thank you. Joe's father has a few words of prayer that he'd like to share with us at this time.
Now I feel cold. I don't need a telephone book to get higher than this. I'm not much of a word, I'll just say what I feel. Gracefully, with courage.
Thank you.
with dignity. I hope when I pass on, I have half that amount. Joe's up there now in spirit, looking down on all of us here, smiling with the same smile you have on those cards that you're looking at, hopefully. Saying thank you for being here. His smile will stay.
Again, thank you.